G'day and welcome back to Build Some, and in this video what I want to show you is a section through a brick veneer house, which is going to be similar to the last video I did, but the main difference with this one will be that it will have a platform floor rather than a concrete slab. So I'm going to go for a timber platform floor. So as you can see, I've got the ground line here and we've dug two different types of footings. This one here is what we call a strip footing, and obviously that would run in a continuous line around the perimeter of the building, and this one here is a blob footing. Okay, and that one's just dug to suit the spacing of the bearers around the house. I'll show you those in a minute. So the first step, once we've excavated around our site, is to reinforce our strip footing. So we can make up a reinforcement cage, which is made up of bars and stirrups, or nowadays we have trench mesh, which is three or four bars already joined together, and we can clip them together, and we set them on top of bar chairs so that they don't sit on the ground. They actually have a little bit of clearance between the ground and the reinforcement, so we get our cover. We also have to make sure that they're not hard up against the edge of the trench as well, so that the reinforcement's not sitting too close to the edge of the concrete and we won't get concrete cancer occurring. So that's our cage, reinforcement cage. With our blob footing, we don't require reinforcement, so it just gets left, and then we can pour our concrete. So what we do is we establish a height that we're going to finish our concrete at, and you can see, similar to our slab, we don't want to see the footing at the end of the job, so we've actually left the footing a little bit lower than the ground line, so we can backfill later on. So that's our strip footing poured, and our blob footing's poured again sitting a little bit lower. Alright, so that's all our concrete done. Then we can get the bricklayer to work, and he's going to construct a dwarf wall, which is just a single skin of brickwork, runs around the outside of the building, again following the strip footing, and it has built into it vents approximately every metre, which allow airflow to get under the house. That keeps the house at a constant temperature, and constant moisture, and allows under the house to dry out and helps to prevent termites from being encouraged in under the house. So the dwarf wall is reinforced with engaged piers, so they're engaged because they're actually up against the dwarf wall, touching it. They are generally tied together with brick ties, so there's actually a wire tie that goes between the two stacks of bricks, the reason for this is, one, to reinforce the wall, and secondly, it provides us somewhere to put our bearers when we start to lay our floor. That's our engaged pier. We also have, on top of our blob footing, isolated or sleeper piers. So obviously they're out here by themselves, so they're isolated. And again, this is spaced far enough apart that our bearer can adequately span the distance. Alright. That's all our brickwork completed for this stage anyway. On top of our brickwork, we need to put our damp proof course, just to prevent any moisture that does get into this brickwork from rising all the way through our house. It's only going to rise just to the damp proof course, which is just underneath our first timber member. So our damp proof course goes in then, and then on top of our damp proof course we put in our end capping. So we have a continuous length of end capping along the dwarf wall with a turn down on one edge. We have a half ant cap, which is made to fit on one brick. It's turned down on three edges, and it's actually joined to the continuous ant cap with a termite approved cork, or like a construction adhesive, and it's pop riveted on so that the termites won't come through the join. And over on our isolated pier, we have a full end cap, which just covers, you know, 2 bricks by 2 bricks, so it's 230 by 230 with your turn down edge on the outside. So again, termites can't work their way up through the brickwork and into our building. On top of our end cap, we can put our bearer in. Notice that the bearer is set 40 mil from the edge of this brick, which is continues our cavity down. You'll see the cavity later. That gives us a gap off this brick to our timber, so moisture can't cross the cavity. And as I said before, it's designed so that its allowable span is the distance here. The other thing with the bearer, or our lowest timber member, it must be no closer to the ground than 400 mil. You can go a little bit bigger, but you can't go any closer to the ground than 400 mil. This helps with for the moisture getting to the timber, and also gives us somewhere to get under the floor and actually inspect our end caps for any termite activity. The next thing is our joists. So because this is a platform floor, I have a double joist on the external wall and then just single joist spaced at the spacing for our flooring. And on top of that goes our platform sheet flooring. So that's the first part of our section for a brick veneer platform floor building. In the next video, I'll continue with the wall frame and have a look at the brick veneer itself.